I am privileged to support motion of thanks on Honorable Presidential Address moved by Sri Sarangiji. Honorable President's Address has illuminated on India's progress attained in diverse fields in the past 5 years and challenges for the immediate future. The House has witnessed scores of addresses from presidents of those respective times. Perhaps this is the only address which reflected the true progress made by a government rather than a bundle of papers chanting undelivered and impractical promises. We stood tall on the global platform with indigenous strength. We have witnessed tangible output from every sector of the economy. It would be a complete leap of truth if I say that these accomplishments have happened as simple as said. There was staged criticism, orchestrated protest, unconventional political amalgamations, selective campaigns, anti-national propagandas, and every caustic exercise under the sun to derail the government and Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji in particular. These were from every corner of the country, but the government battled every stage of this corrosive environment and evolved into productive mode, which made us stand where we are now. But the propagandists, while performing these inappropriate stunts, have not realized that the mighty common man is watching them with their eyes wide open. What happened next? They have come out in large numbers like never before, stood in the scorching sun in long lines and wielded their weapon, vote. Women, as said by Honorable President, they came out in numbers equal to men and clearly have given their mandate. I say with utmost pride that my parliamentary segment has significantly more female voter turnout than male voter turnout. The result is I am here. And to be precise, it was 1,10,000 more women voters who have casted their vote in my segment than men. And the reason is, most importantly, the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, aimed at providing house for poor, is a marvel as it caters to the primitive need of every person to have a comfortable living space. Women are worshipped in our country as deities. She is the spine of a family. To have her lead a life with self-respect and security is our collective responsibility. We have witnessed how the phenomenal Swachh Bharat enriched the self-respect of daughters, sisters and mothers. But women of my state are denied of such self-respect when funds allotted under this scheme are diverted to other flagship schemes of state government, the CAG report says it. With ever-rising prices of lands and constructive materials, it has become impossible for the poor and the low-income groups to aspire for a house of their own. The central government has been delivering this humongous task of building houses for the poor in the country with great vigil. I have recently come across from various credible news sources that the government might consider, if feasible, a new housing rental plan in crowded metros for the migrant workers below 3 lakh income. Having lived in a metro for a long time, I have come across thousands of migrant workers sleeping on the footpaths, public gardens, railway stations in harsh climatic conditions. This kind of understanding of every micro aspect of life and addressing its problems has probably made our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi dear to people of this nation. Providing every poor of this nation with a pakka house by 2022 is possible, as addressed by Honorable President, with collective efforts from state and center, unlike my state, which is immune to the aspiration of people to have a house of their own. Ayushman Bharat, the world's largest health insurance system, is a boon to millions of families where medical expenses are costing lifelong savings of individuals. Unfortunately, few states, one being mine, Telangana, has not opted for this scheme. The reasons are apparent: political hegemony issues, vested interest, and of course the sedimented apathy towards the poor people's lives. I seriously cannot contemplate how parties prioritize egos over people who trusted and elected them.